it's very Instagram friendly. The colors are very bright. You know, I have Polish food and Russian food, but brown food, it always looks, no, it doesn't look appealing. So Israeli food is yellow and green and red. It's like a street light, and it works in Instagram, so it gets promoted. Let's talk a bit about hummus. You think that you're smart, and you came to Limud, so you know everything about Israel, and in Israel we are Jewish, and we believe in God. Wrong. First of all, there's a huge Arab minority in Israel, Muslim, Christian, so we're not all Jewish. And secondly, we do not believe in God. We believe in hummus. This is our God. So just to show you how sensitive the hummus issue is, you know that we live in a pretty rough neighborhood in the Middle East. A few years ago, we were sued. We, Israel, were sued by our neighbors from the north, by the Lebanese, in the international court in Den Haag, in the Netherlands, for stealing their two national dishes, tabbouleh and hummus. Now this may sound a bit weird, but if you're familiar with the term of appellation in French means calling something by its proper name. So you know there are some dishes in the world that are sort of patented. For instance,
tequila.
A good Chardonnay is a good Chardonnay, but only if it comes from Chablis, it's a Chablis. And a wonderful blue cheese is wonderful, but only if it comes from Roquefort, it's a Roquefort, etc., etc., etc. And then claimed that hummus is Lebanese. Therefore, if we market hummus around the world, as we do, we may not call it hummus. We can call it chickpea puree, we can call it whatever we wish, not hummus. Well, they lost. Because apparently hummus is not patented, it doesn't have an appellation. And anyways, we claim that hummus was mentioned in the Bible. When David meets Ruth in the field, he says in Hebrew, Boi tivli pitech b'chomets. Come and dip your bread in vinegar. Chomets is vinegar. But we claim that this is a writer's mistake because chomets and chomets are not vinegar. And nobody eats bread with vinegar. So they must have been having, you know, foods. And anyways, it's ridiculous to claim that some food belongs to some people because, first of all, in excavations of, you know, the Neanderthals in the Carmel Mountain, they already found chickpeas in the cave. So way before there were Arabs and way before there were Jews, there was hummus. And, you know, these fights are ridiculous. But they keep happening. So, a few years ago, a bunch of Israeli cooks from a village called Abu Ghosh. Abu Ghosh is sort of the middle of the road between Jerusalem and Tel Aviv. It's an Arab village. And it's known for its hummus. Everybody wants to have hummus at Abu Ghosh. And a bunch of Arab chefs from Abu Ghosh decided to set the Guinness World Record of the biggest hummus plate ever served. And they made a huge plate of hummus. Eventually it will cook, don't worry, but I like talking. And they made a huge plate of hummus, and indeed they were awarded, they were recognized as holding the Guinness World Record for the biggest hummus plate ever served. The Lebanese heard that and said this is a crying shame. They made a bigger plate of hummus, and they were the champions. The guys from Abu Ghosh said, Abu Ghosh is near Neve Ilan. Neve Ilan is where all the television transmission is done from. So they have huge satellite dishes. They filled a satellite dish with hummus, and they got the Guinness World Record. The Lebanese said, They made an even bigger hummus plate of 10,214 kilos of hummus because this is, the land of Lebanon is 10,214 square kilometers. So 1 kilo for each square kilometer, and now they won the war. And I say, our dear friends, may you win all these wars. It's okay. If you want to win the hummus wars, it's yours. Because, you know, again, I think it belongs to everybody. Try to tell Israelis that hummus belongs to everybody. The fights we have in Israel between Jerusalemites and Tel Avivians about hummus are because, you know, Jerusalemites think that we know everything. You know, we have the hummus of the old city and we have the hummus of the Arab neighborhoods. We know everything. And Tel Avivians, what do they know? They sit in cafes all day long, do branding or all sorts of things that are, you know, Luftgeschäft. Exactly. This is no place for hummus. But they think that they know everything because Tel Aviv is adjacent to Jaffa, and in Jaffa there is Abu Hassan, and if you feed to Abu Hassan, then you know everything. Even the hand movement with which you eat the hummus is different between Jerusalem and Tel Aviv. If you come from Jerusalem, where obviously you're a settler, you're a man with hair on your chest, and you eat your hummus like this, in a straight line, like a Neanderthal. And we call it in Arabic, beduf, in a straight line. In Tel Aviv, since we're all gay intellectuals, we eat our hummus with a round hummus, with your pinky standing up. So later on, when you have your hummus, you may have the Jerusalem, like, where is Tel Aviv? You'll decide, God loves everybody, she told me so.